Alright, so good morning class. So welcome back to our online class, alright? So this year there are a few things which you need to learn in your syllabus, alright? So since it's the first class, in your class 12 syllabus, there is a topic called intellectual property law, alright? I'll be sending you the entire syllabus in PDF format later on. But today we are going to start with topic called intellectual property law in legal studies. Alright? So, before we start, what is the meaning, what is the concept of intellectual property act? Let us try to understand it. Now, when the term comes intellectual, what do we understand? Intellectual means something which you create by your own. You are creative, you are innovative, isn't it? Your brain is smarter, isn't it? We call a person, he is an intellectual person. Why? Because his thoughts are innovative, his creations are creative, he has a good innovation skills, alright? So because of that, a person can be termed as an intellectual person. An intellectual person, but Vidwan Manche in Nepali. Alright? So there is a law called intellectual property law in our country. Now the reason why the intellectual property law has been introduced or has been enacted is because to protect all those creations, innovation made by a person. Alright, so this is the reason why intellectual property has been added. Now let's start. Intellectual property rights are the legal rights that cover the privileges given to an individual who are the owner and inventors of a work and have created something with their intellectual creativity. So, what is intellectual property rights? It is a right given to a person or to an owner. It is a privileges or it is a protection to a person or an individual or owner who has created something using his intellectual creativity. Alright, who has created something by using his intellectual creativity. Individuals related to areas such as literature, music, invention, etc. can be granted such rights which can be used in the business practice by them. Now, what is intellectual property all about? For an example, if I write a novel, right? I am a writer, alright? If I write a novel, then that novel written by me is my creation. I am the owner of that novel, isn't it? Because that novel has been written by me. And in order to write those novel or that novel, I have used my intellectual thoughts, isn't it? I have used my creativity so that I can write a novel or a book. Another example is, if I am a musician and I create a music, alright? I create a good music. Now, I have created that music using my creation, isn't it? I have created that music using my creation. So, I will be the whole owner. Now, in order to protect my creativity, in order to protect my creation, intellectual property has been introduced so that others won't steal my artwork. Supposing, if I create a music or if I write a novel, someone comes and steal it. In tomorrow's time, if someone will come and tells that no, it was composed, it was written by me, then my hard work, my creativity, which I have used using my thoughts, my creation, my intellectual thoughts will be go in vain, isn't it? So in order to protect those things of a person or an owner, the concept of intellectual property has been alright? Now, what are the things which can be added which comes under Intellectual Property Act? First of all, if it is in the field of literature, as I have already given, if I write a novel, a drama, a poem, whatever story, whatever, that can be protected. In tomorrow's time, nobody can come and claim it that no, this was written by me. Alright? So, that artwork of mine has been protected under Intellectual Property Act. Now another one. in the form of music, or in the form of art, or in the form of any creativity which has been created by me or by an individual using his or her own thought. And remember one thing, that creativity, that innovation, that whatever it is, it has to be new, it has to be original. Alright? We all know what is original, isn't it? So if a song comes in YouTube, for example, there is a band, and if that band comes up with a new song, or a pop star, if that person comes up with a new song, that has to be his own origin. It can't be a cover. It can't be a cover song. But that has to be original. This is what it is trying to tell us. Now, moving on to next is the main purpose for having Intellectual Property Act. The main purpose for having intellectual property law is that the creator or the inventor gets exclusive rights against any misuse or use of work without his or her prior information. So what is the main purpose? The second point, the main purpose of having Intellectual Property Act. Why Intellectual Property Act has been introduced? The main reason is it protects the creativity of a creator or an inventor. Alright? And it not only protects it, but it also gives exclusive rights to the owners. Now we must remember this term. It gives exclusive rights. For example, if I have created a music, or if I have painted a new painting, or if I have written a new book, I will be the owner. Alright? So it will give me exclusive right to do whatever of my innovation. I can either sell it or I can either keep it. Alright? So it gives exclusive right to whom? To the owner. Or if, for an example, it's me, then it will give me exclusive rights so that I can do whatever I can with my innovations. Alright? So this is the first and foremost point. And second thing, we must always remember, it also protects the inventor. Now, protection over here, how can it protect? It can protect my innovation by not giving or not allowing them to steal my innovations, my belongings, my thoughts, my creativity. Alright? So, there are two points for having intellectual property law or intellectual property act. First, it gives exclusive rights to the owner, and the second part is it protects the owner or the creativity of an owner. Alright? So, moving on to the next one is the following list of activities which are covered by the intellectual property rights are laid down by the World Intellectual Property Organization. Remember, there is an organization called World Intellectual Property Organization, also known as WIPO. So, this WIPO or this organization has categorized what can be termed or what can be under Intellectual Property Act. So what are they? Number one, industrial designs, scientific discoveries, literature works, artistic and scientific works, trademarks, service marks, commercial names and designations. So later on, we'll all discuss what are these all about. Alright, but before we end today's class, in intellectual property, there are various types of acts which has been included under or which comes under Intellectual Property Act. So what are they? If this is intellectual property, this is a whole body, right? So there are four types of intellectual property rights. Number one is copyright. Another one is Design Act. Another one is Patent. Another one is Trademark. So So under intellectual property law, there are basically four types of laws which are included under WIPO or under the Indian law. So there are the copyrights, the Designers Act, Patent, Trademark Act. The Designers Act can also be termed as industrial mark. Alright, so this will be discussed in our next class. What are these four types of acts which has been included under intellectual property law? Alright, so if you have any questions, you can text me or you can even call me up in my WhatsApp number. Alright, so this much for the day, and hope you guys have understood the concept. Alright, so thank you.